Hey guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. This is 9th video of game development in Python with Pygames. So in last video we have seen about how to increase the length of the snake, and in this video we are going to talk about two things. First thing is that whenever snake touch itself, that time we are going to quit that game, or we are going to make a game or is equal to true. Okay, the another thing is that we are going to learn today is that we are going to display a live score order on our game window or a game surface. Okay, so let me run our previous code, and here you can see that whenever the snake eat that apple, that time you can see that the length of the snake is increased by 1. Okay, so here I want to show you one thing. That's why here I am going to increase the length of the snake, let's say by 30. So whenever the snake touches itself like this, that time we are going to quit game, or we are going to make game or is equal to true. So basically what logic that we are going to apply, or what logic that we are going to use for this scenario. Okay, so in our snake game, thus in our snake, the first block, it is known as a head. Okay, and the other block is known as a block, basically. Okay, so basically whenever the first head part touch any other body part, that time we are going to match the coordinates. If both coordinates are same, so that time we are going to just make game or is equal to true. Okay, so just do this thing in our code. So here I am going to create one if statement, if head, so that is a first block of our snake, if head in snake list. So here I am going to use slicing, snake list colon minus 1. Okay, so what does that mean? So basically snake list colon minus 1 contain all the coordinate of the all that blocks except head block. Okay, so whenever head touch any other block, that time the head coordinate will automatically append on snake list. Okay, so after that snake touch the head part of snake touch any other part, that time the snake, the head coordinate will append on this snake list, and that time we are simply going to make game or is equal to true. Okay, so now you can see that our game is quit. Okay, so let's do this again. Okay, so if you have any query or any problem in this line of code, so you can just ask me in comment section below. Okay, so let's talk about the another thing. We are going to display a live score on our display or a surface. Okay, so in Pygame it is not that much easy to directly we can write a score on our game window. For creating a text, we have to create some objects in our Pygame. Okay, so first object that we are going to make, that is a font object. Okay, so here I am going to create one font object outside of our while loop. So font is equal to Pygame dot font dot capital SYS dot font. Okay, and inside that you have to pass few parameters. First parameter will be a name of your font or a style of your font. Right now here I am going to pass none. That means it will consider font from the system. Okay, so it will get the font from the system by default font. The second parameter is that you can pass the size of your font. So let's say here I am going to pass 25. Okay, now let's make another object, render object. So I am going to create a render object inside our while loop. So let's make that. I am going to create one variable screen text, and inside that I am going to make font dot render. Okay, so basically font dot render, so basically font dot render convert your text into one image. Okay, so after that you can set that image on your game window or a game surface. Inside your font dot render you have to pass few parameters. First parameter will be string. So let's say here I am going to pass one app string, let's say score. Okay, and the score will be length of your snake. Okay, so here I am going to pass snake length. Now another parameter will be true or false. If you want to activate the anti-aliasing, so you can simply pass true, and if you do not want to activate that, you can simply pass false. Okay, so here I am going to pass true. The third parameter will be color of your text. So here I am going to pass a white color. Okay, so here I am going to pass a RGB value of white color. RGB value of white color is a 255, 255 and 255. Okay, now we created a render object of that text. Okay, so now time is to display that text on our game window. Okay, so we are going to just do game display dot plate. So basically this function will show your text on your game window. Okay, so inside that game display dot plate, you have to first pass screen text. Okay, the another parameter will be a starting coordinate of your text. So you can pass it as a list or tuple. So here I'm going to pass as a list, so let's say 50 50. Okay, so let's run our code. I'm going to run this code. Okay, so now here you can see that here we are getting a live score. Okay, if I eat that apple, if our snake eat that apple, so okay, so let me just decrease the snake length. Okay, so now here you can see that you can see the live updating of the score. Okay, so here you can see that. So inside this none, okay, pygame.font.sys font, inside this none you can pass any font you want. In pygame there are lots of fonts available. Okay, so if you want to check those fonts, so you can. Okay, so first I am going to open my command prompt and let's say python import pygame, and here I am going to show all the fonts available in pygame. Okay, so for I in pygame dot font dot get underscore fonts, and I will give print I. So here you can see that there are lots of fonts available in our pygame. Okay, so let me just here copy one font and I am going to paste this font inside this none part. Okay, now you can see that the font is now changed. Okay, so you can check all of this font. Okay, so guys, that's it for this video. If you have any question, query or comment, you can just ask me in comment section below, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe this channel. Thanks for watching this video.